This isn't something I normally talk about. I never openly discuss my feelings and how it affected me. The fact that I am making this video knowing 100 plus people are going to watch it is a huge deal. Not to mention, it is very hard for me. This isn't a pity story. My story is about taking a hard situation and making the best out of it. Not letting something bad ruin you, but instead make you stronger. My parents' divorce was very hard on me. Unless you've experienced it for yourself, you don't truly understand the toll it can take on you. It can honestly ruin everything. Your whole outlook on life, your mood, your grades, divorce can destroy everything. My video isn't about how devastating divorce is. It's about how it made me stronger. It turned me into the person I am today. I believe in letting a terrible thing make you stronger. Being strong isn't just physical. It's not binging 250 pounds or running a 5-minute mile. But being strong is thinking your way through a problem or doing what's right even though no one else is. You are strong when you stick up for the kid being bullied or doing something that everyone else says you can't. I never realized how strong every single one of us is. Going to the hospital to support your classmates' family in such a terrible time, even though it is hard, is strong. We're all strong in our own ways. I believe I became strong when my parents split up. My story starts 2 years ago at the end of my sophomore year. My parents were constantly fighting about everything. Being in a good mood was hard. I would take my 9-year-old brother in my room and watch TV all the time to get away from it. My parents didn't put us in the middle of their fights. They weren't mean to us. They tried their best to keep us out of it, but it still got to me. There was always tension, always wondering what their next fight would be. Finally, one Sunday night after the fair, my dad walked into my room, kissed me on the forehead, and told me to clean it. When he told me he loved me, I didn't know that would be the last time my dad would be home. I didn't know how broken my home would be. The next few weeks were hard. My mother and my brother were always upset. I only cried the first few days. I then composed myself and I was there for my mom. I only cried when I was alone. The days were long and the nights were even longer. Something just wasn't right at home. Something was missing. My dad was missing. I didn't talk about it to anyone. I tried to put a smile on my face for my dad. It seemed like every day I was telling my mom it would be okay. I mean, if I said it enough times, it would have to be true, right? When I went to school, I only told a few of my closest friends that my dad had left. I always tried to smile and not let anyone know how torn apart I was. I didn't let my grades drop or use divorce as an excuse. I became stronger. I no longer cried. I didn't blame my mom for making my dad leave, and I didn't hate my dad for leaving. I never complained or said I didn't use my homework because my life was hard. I wasn't angry anymore. I hardly ever saw my father, and I didn't let it ruin me. Instead, I tried harder to see him. I believe in being strong. I started to actually smile, and I accepted the fact that my life had changed, and so I had to change. Things could have been a whole lot worse for me, but they weren't. I still had good grades, my friends, and two parents who still loved me. I didn't let it get to me. I let it make me a bigger person. I became stronger. I love my parents, and I am no longer mad at them. This is the first time that I have came out to talk about this. Usually I write about it in my papers, but that's for Mrs. Ramey's eyes only. I've never actually talked about my parents' divorce in front of such a big group of people like I am today. This, I believe, I am strong.